Hello friends, I want to express heartiest welcome to all on this centenary talk of one of the greatest industrialists and physicists of India. A good teacher is like a candle. It consumes itself to light the way for others. The same way, breadth of Vikram Sarabhai's interest were remarkable. In spite of his work and involvement in scientific research, he was actively interested in establishing industries, empowering business and development related issues. Today, on the occasion of 101st birthday, we are going to discuss about his contribution with an intention to learn from his lifestyle with our resource person, Professor R. Ilangovan. A quick introduction for our organization for those who are new to our channel. Our organization Team 2020 Helping Hands is a group for students, entrepreneurs and society. We aim to create a network of potential helpers to raise their helping hands towards those who are in need and who need to be helped. Follow our LinkedIn page to know more. I am CEO and founder of Team 2020, and it is an honor for us to introduce our most valuable speaker, Professor R. Ilangovan, on this occasion to facilitate our students and faculty members. Professor Ilangovan has been an ex-colleague of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam and a professor at KCG Institute of Technology. He is having a remarkable experience in research and development at Vikram Sarabhai Space Center, ISRO, and also an academic experience of 14 years. I would like to request our professor to take over the session. Please, sir.
So this is a tribute to Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, father of Indian space program. This is a centenary. It's 12th August 1919. So it is 100 years over of a big legend. Right. We will pay a small tribute to him on his centenary day. Right. So it is a 100th day. You can see that from the itself, it is a, ISRO is a major contribution to the country, which is of the first time, right, in the country, right. So we'll start now. Choosing to lead one kind of life means putting aside the desire to pursue other options. Yes, it's completely correct for him, because he never, just with one, he never stopped. He's a team builder, motivational builder, institutional builder, and he has a wide range of life means putting aside the desire to pursue other. He has lot of options from textile to space, we can say, along atomic route. So he start from his beginning. We can see that he is a scientist, scientific research. He's a science man, physics, major research in the physics, and he's an institutional builder and a democratic technocrat and father of the space. And parallelly, he was a policy maker and a planner and a team builder. Okay, these are inside. Finally, he reached a stage of from a scientific research to father of space. Right, he becomes Sarabhai, the man with a vision. But ISRO is his vision. Actually, he derived his vision from our late Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. So from the great man, he derived the vision and make it as a mission. But his vision is mission for all of us. So he was with good, great leaders, right? And ended up with the Padma Bhushan in 1972 after his demise. He was, till the date, he was with the great leaders of the nation and used their connection for the benefit of the nation to getting through all the things. Right. He's a dreamer. He used to say, I have a dream, like and a fantasy maybe, that we can leapfrog our way to development. There are two words, very important word is leapfrog. This we used to use it every time he used to use this. I think our Kalam also derived, actually inherited this word from Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, the word dream. Right? It's a self-reliance. Right? Block, we never, you want to buy something from abroad, yes, to cut short the time. But don't get to occur as a block boxes from abroad, but to grow a national capability. He's a man who block boxes, that he grow the national capability. That's a major important point. Right? He has to leapfrog. That is the reason why one of his followers has written a book called Leapfroggers by V.P. Sandas, one of his close associates. Vikram Sarabhai Space Center, very close associate of Dr. Kalam. Yeah, after that, he written a book called Leap Progress. We go to go like a leap. We need not continuously jump. You have to one jump, then to get the momentum and then jump. Like that only, he has executed a lot of projects from his textile to space of the SLV. Right, and he inaugurated the PRL. So communication is listening. He's a very close and people listen to him because of his sincerity. Right, either it is Indira Gandhi or Nehru. So he is a man with a lot of network connection. Right, leaders of the nation, the great leaders. Right, we are starting with child. We'll slowly go through community his child from childhood to up to his getting his Padma Bhushan. Post-mortem at the age of 7. So he is a blessed child. And we never, this many people visited his house during his childhood time. You see that Gandhiji, starting from Gandhiji, Motilal, Jawaharlal Nehru, Indira Gandhi, Tagore, Jagadish Chandra Bose, General Sarkar, C.V. Raman, Rukmani Arindale, J. Krishnamurthy, Prithviraj Kapoor, you say Tata Malaysar, Sardar Patel. Like these many people during his young days, this many great, all the political, religious, right? And all the people used to visit his retreat where he was studying in during his days. So this was, he is a blessed child indeed. And nobody has this much rich and luxurious childhood, right? He actually, blessing of Tagore was there. Once he visited Tagore, visiting house, this boy will achieve great things. This is a comment of the Rabindranath Tagore about Vikram Sarabhai when he was young. Right. So these are the people, some symbol of people who have visited. Right? And you to use a young size in his land, you to write letter to himself, because no letter is coming for him in the young. So you want some address to him. So let us say he was in all letters as a postal stamp. Right. His figure is appeared in the postal stamp. Where in the childhood he wished to be receive a lot of letters from others. So he should write for himself. Write a letter every day to himself so that a letter is coming every day and his father find out it one day. Right? This is one of the, he's always on the move, on the train. Right. 1937. He completed his intermediate examination at Gujarat College, Ahmedabad, and joined St. John's College, Cambridge, UK. Actually, who recommended him to Cambridge is Rabindranath Tagore. He has given a letter, recommendation letter for him to get into the Cambridge UK. Remember, at the same time, the Mayor Indira Gandhi also was studying in the UK, but in different college, Oxford. So, this is some of his figure, young Vikram Veng and handsome Vikram Sarabhai at the UK as a student. Right, 1940, Institute of Science. He came back, joined the, because the World War broken. So he has returned to India and joined Indian Institute of Science in 1940 with the agreement, with the permission to continue his PG courses at Indian Institute of Science. There only he became the student of Dr. Nobel Prize Sir C.V. Raman. Under him he joined as a student, and there is a turning point, a lot of turning point at Bangalore at Indian Institute of Science. So he is very close to Sir C.V. Raman in the letter says also, he continues his effort. And a young graduate student of C.V. Raman and his later supervisor, Milligan. So he has three Nobel laureates. He has worked for his thesis. You will wonder. With the service Raman and him, Milligan, and two, three people, through Nobel Prize winners, have gone through his PhD thesis before he is getting a PhD. Right, he gave Sir C.V. Raman the stipend of 30 rupees at the time. He continued his course. But he met Baba Baba, you'll be knowing atomic research. You met Baba in IIC, and actually was senior, 10 years senior to Vikram Sarabhai. Almost their career is same. Both of them big Atomic Energy Commission chairman in the later stages. So he was a very good follower of Baba. And you can see the photos with him, the meetings. He is 1942. He released his scientific research paper in the Proceedings of Indian Academy of Sciences, volume 15, page 18, you can see that. At the same time, he married Bharathanatyam Lakshman, Minnani Swaminathan at Bangalore. This is a marriage photo, and his son, Karthikeya Sarabhai. Yesterday also he gave a lecture at ISRO headquarters, Ahmedabad. Right? These are some of his with his family photos. Right? He, again, 1945 of the World War, he returned to Cambridge to work for his PhD in cosmic ray physics. And he come back with the PhD and returned to India. In 1947 itself, he is starting two, his first is ATIRA and PRL at Ahmedabad. This is what I'm telling. Immediately, he is after a PhD in physics, and immediately come back because he grew up in a textile family, industrial family. So immediately got ATIRA, Ahmedabad Textile Industry Research Association. Started ATIRA in the same year, 1947 itself, and PRL, Public Research Laboratory, is a really huge concern now. Where a lot of people has come from that, like Dr. U.R. Rao, ex-chairman ISRO, is also from there. Right? Management of Sarabhai Chemicals, 1955. Again, Sugrit Gaiji Limited, Baroda. Took over the management of Swastika Oil Mills Limited, Bombay. Founded the Ahmedabad Management Association. This is all the things are consecutive, like a waterfall, one by one. That is the reason why we are telling you it's an institutional builder. Right? 58, Sarabhai Merck Limited, Baroda. It is called Sarabhai Chemicals. Took over the management standard pharmaceutical of Calcutta. He started the Sarabhai Research Center, Baroda. Right? He also had the Operation Research Group, ORG, first market research organization in the country. Right? 61. Right? Sarabhai Engineering Group. Again, Sarabhai Glasses. Prestigious SS Bhatnagar Award for his scientific and research physics. Appointment as chairman of Inco Spar, founded the IIM Ahmedabad, selected the president of physics section, Indian Science Congress, Cuttack. You see that. All founder, chairman, all these things one by one. And he has result NASA 66. He has a satellite instrument television experiment, was launched during 1975. Julie when Dr. Sarabhai is no more. Right? As a result of his dialogue with NASA in 1966, at the same time, appointed as chairman of Atomic Energy Commission. Same time, he also heading the space. Sir, at the DIA, Government of India, Chairman of Electronics Committee, founded the Nehru Foundation, member International Council of Scientific Union, and so on. So, Padma Vibhushan is an Indian scientist. He awarded Padma Bhushan. Right? Set up Uranium Corporation. See, in the 90s, he was very active at that time, ECS. He was the chairman of COSPAR. Consultative group of potentially harmful effects for space experiments. He presented a paper. He's 1968. He is scientific chairman of the UN Conference on the Exploration and the Peaceful Uses of Outer Spaces, Vienna. Right? He constituted ISRO, became chairman ISRO, signed a SIT agreement with NASA USA, president of 4th General Conference, International Atomic Energy Agency, and president profile, as I told you, president profile also there, president Indian Geophysical Union. 1971, scientific chairman, 4th UN Conference on the Peaceful Uses of Atomic Energy. 70 awarded Padma Vibhushan posthumously. 1974, a moon crater was named after Dr. Vikram Sarabhai by the International Association of Astronomical Union at Sydney, Australia. Right? Serenity was known as Sarabhai, that was a vessel in the Sea of Serenity is called Sarabhai Crater. Right? Vibhushan is a crater. Sarabhai crater, a small sacrifice named after him after his death. Right. Right? He always showed leaf frogging. What is his qualities? Let us see that. He always used the phrase leaf frogging. That means technology and science, we must leapfrog to achieve the goal. That was his major this one. He used to tell the people leapfrog. Don't be slow. Always active. Right. However, absolute technologies has to be replaced. and tailor-made to our own country. But we adopt a lot of foreign technologies, but we make it suit to our country. No time should be wasted. Right? Time should not be wasted. What is new and advanced developments are to be borrowed and made part of our betterment. It must be borrowed. You are not hesitate to borrow any advanced technology from abroad. Like I told you, Rohini Sahuja is mad. He got it from NASA. Right? But he tailor-made to our country. Right? That's what is code for an institutional builder. Director of, see, new combination of skills and completeness is one of the ideas. Director of Indian Agricultural Research Institute and in Indian Agriculture, ICAR, he combined with the nuclear scientist. Right? ICAR and the Department of Energy combined for the agricultural to the resources to support the ICAR. Another joint venture in the government. Another way started was between All India Radio and Excellent Satellite Communication Earth Station. So television as an instrument for mass communication. You worried about the poor people. So he bring the technology to the benefit of the poor people. A labor manager. So that's why the labor management, he took keen interest in solving the problem between the management and the employees by employing the relation techniques which experimental proved useful through another organization. That's called ATIRA. That's what we discussed. A democratic outlook. Delegation of powers, right? All these are his qualities. He is a policy maker and planner. COSPAR, right? The International Council for Scientific, I see what known as the International Council for Science and Science, a committee on space research in 1958. COSPAR, that he formed, 1958. India interested in this one, looking up space research to the DIE, the Baba as a secretary, the next year. The Indian National Committee on Space Research Board. And Vikram Sarabhai was the chairman. This is the start of the space age. Right. So in RH, Rohini 79, he worked with the team. He formed the team by working with them. Right? Whether it's explaining to DFR. Right. So he completed the Sri Gurukota range, SSTC, Dhawan Space Center, now what is known as Dhawan Space Center, Satish Dhawan Space Center. And the Space Science and Technology Center, SSCC, Trivandrum, all these are his formations. He sent a small committee to NASA also, right? Yeah, he sent a small group to NASA to learn about grounded rockets. So to Goddard Space Flight Center, Wallops Science and Faculty, all the Kalam went to Wallops Science Center, and some of the people went to Goddard Space Flight Center, and the Central Detail CNES. All these things, he sent his team to all over world to get the technology and make it use for his India. This is his philosophy, right? Lot of things he achieved from started from a church, he space research organization, and he has a BRL at the same time at Village Trivandrum. He is from a small to 1971, he built here big lodging complexes. These are the institutions what he built, PHRL. Sorry, PRL, Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad, Community Science Center, Ahmedabad, Durban Academy of Arts. This is for Arts Salam, which is why Vikram Sarabhai Space Center, Trivandrum, Space Application Center, Ahmedabad, Faster Beta Test Reactor, Kalpakkam, Variable Energy Project, Calcutta. All these, that is why we call him, he is an institutional builder. Right? He pointed out the Rohini series, later series was named as Menaka and Rohini. Right, this is where he wanted to use television as a medium of mass communication. Along with he organized the event. It is for the mass communication, yes. Right, at the same time, he launched Nikki Apache. That is the first sounding rocket in November 1963. That way, that marks the birth of the thirds, what we call a thirds, is a Tumba Equatorial Rocket Launch Station. That is the starting of the space age by launching Nikki Apache. Right? It's okay. This you can skip this to this one. These are all known. These are the awards, Padma Bhushan awarded in 9 posthumously. And an achievement, this is Padma Bhushan. Yeah, sorry. So from we'll come to this with the involvement in space. It started in a small village near this one. This is a church where we started our research. So here only the sounding rockets are prepared. and launched from here in 1970s. This is SSTC. Actually, this is a room where Kalam used to sit here, and I used to sit here. That's the reason why. The same floor, you can see that. So, from ISR formed 15th August, all 1960 to 1969, these are all the contribution of Dr. Vikram Sarabhai. It is a Indian National Competitive Formation in COSPA, first sounding rocket, space science technology, satellite telecom, IR-1 atomic energy. So, all these things as a part of this, permanent department of atomic energy after 1969 is all of them major team building effort or institutional building or a technical democratic difficulty. Right? This is where the research was there. Actually, these were church. Now it is a museum now where we have placed all over this one. See, actually, you go and meet the bishop because at that time we want 1 square mile for Tumba, one square mile. 1 square mile area we want. In that 1 square mile, this, the church was there. The bishop was there. So he went and talked to the bishop. And Saturday and Sunday, he attended the mosque. And bishop, he convinced the bishop to get the church for the research. So this is what Kalam is narrating, how he met, how the spirituality met the science. That's what he used to tell. So he went and talked to the people, and the bishop talked to the people, and we got the church for the research. Now you can see that. These are now the recent look of the control center, or the recent look of Tumba rocket sounding rocket landing. This is where Baba was a dream, lot of assignments. He was with the great people, Sadhis Bhatnagar, Homi Sabha, C. V. Raman, and with Nehru in Kaspar in 1962, so in Christian. So always. And Prime Minister had letter visit to the experimental satellite, all the things. He was with the great people. But always he believed in the one thing, he who can listen to the music in the midst of noise can achieve great things. With a lot of environment, lot of problem, lot of this one, he listened to the music in between the noise. That is his perfect performance. So he not only that, now international, it is our Neil Armstrong, the first man who landed on the moon also met. So I visited India, Tata Institute, he has a TAFR he received. Then Neil Armstrong for his institute. So he was impressed with all the things. Who can listen? This is his most word, right? And he respected time, always on the meeting everywhere, meeting will be there. Whether in the hotel room or in the office, the hotel room will be meeting there. There will be meeting in the department. Then the meeting will be carried out to his hotel room. Then when he travel to Bombay back, again in the airport, there will be meeting. And if it is not over, he will ask the people to take the ticket and come in the aircraft. Then the aircraft itself, there will be meeting. And the people, there are a lot of incidents. People gone with him and meet and then return back in the next flight to same place. So this is what his way of conducting meeting. He waste no time. Right? These are his experience overall. So he changed the complete scene entire now. Just to Mangalyaan. That's what he grew through ISRO. Right? So as the SLV days, we can see what is common about the various people. Kalam is to tell, I was spotted as a young scientist by Dr. Vikram Sarabhai. And what he's telling is, see, he was once Kalam was told, there was a phone call from Vikram Sarabhai, and he requested Kalam to come to Hotel Asoha, Delhi. He was, Dr. Vikram Sarabhai was staying there. So he went at night, 3 o'clock he met me. This is the time given to Kalam to meet him, right? 3 o'clock. So Kalam went there after changing so many flights. In honor is and his usual sail, interesting sail, he went there and met. And there was another gentleman also came when he was waiting for Kalam in the reception. And another man also came. Both of them were waiting for Dr. Vikram Sarabhai. Exactly 3 o'clock, Dr. Vikram Sarabhai came. And he took him to the Air Force station at Delhi. And showed him one aircraft, Air Force plane, that you want to fit a rocket assisted takeoff. That concept I want fit in this aircraft. Can you kindly, both of you, help? I will get the motors from Russia. Can you do that? Then yes, then everybody asked him, right? Could you do it in 18 months time? So this was a challenge given to Kalam. This was written by Kalam. They agreed and they developed this. It's called RETO. He developed it. Another is his optimism is contagious. He's very optimistic. And it will spread to everybody. And he get the people. Once Kalam failed in two, two of the sounding rockets locked in the initial period, was a failure. It all went to the sea. Then Kalam was very much felt sad and afraid. And next day he should report to Dr. Vikram Sarabhai. He went to his hotel room and before he is starting, and Vikram sir told, gave him a cover and asked him to open. When Kalam opened the cover, it was a promotion letter. Then Kalam told, sir, these are the two things. Then you don't worry, you are going in the right direction. And you are a busy bee. You will definitely do well. And say, that is the way he motivates. Even some error is there, he will contain that. He will not fire for that. But he will take the positive achievement, accomplish whatever accomplished, take that. And he will engage and motivate the team. That is why he became a team builder and a motivator. The same method we can see in the history of Kalam also. Same kind of incident happened where Dr. Kalam sir has taken the Vikram Sarabhai's place and he has got the same motivated the youngsters. So the motivation of Kalam, we can see it is from Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, the way in which Kalam was treated. He treated all the other youngsters. So this is what Kalam met at Delhi at the NATO. See, he was out of BMLE. So there was a who has to finish some telemetry command. At the time, two people were working well. One is Dr. Madhavan Nair, so working under Dr. Kalam, early days. He was a chairman, became the chairman. And another, U.R. Rao, he also became the chairman. U.R. Rao is a student of Dr. Vikram Sarabhai. Right, the physics, he is from PR, physics is a laboratory, Ahmedabad. And Madhavan Nair working under Dr. Kalam. But Dr. Kalam recommended Madhavan Nair, but he, Vikram Sarabhai accepted, preferred, he was for that. Then there was a tremendous growth for Dr. Madhavan Nair. He became the chairman, as you know that. So even though he's a student, we are now, he didn't support. He wanted the correct person for the correct job. That is his motive. Right? Once there was a review was going on, Dr. Kalam was presenting. At the time, SLV stages were, first stage was Dr. Vasant Gavrikar. Second stage was a group. Third stage was by A. Muthunayam, Dr. A. Muthunayam. All are big shots who were trained in abroad. And fourth stage by Dr. Kalam and full vehicle is by Dr. Kalam. When everybody stage, everybody presented their stage details. When a Dr. Kalam term, the fourth stage comes, he asked his team to present. This is his team, Kalam's team. He asked his team to present. But at the time, so somebody stopped him. No, what you have done? All of us have presented them. Your team has done everything. What you have done was asked to Kalam. Suddenly Kalam, Vikram Sarabhai got angry. And talk, no, this is called the project integration. I expect the project manager to integrate the project than to involve himself more in the project. So this was the way of his functioning style of Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, as told by Kalam himself. So, next one is VP Sandlas. VP Sandlas is one of the pioneer engineer of Vikram Sarabhai Space Center. And he was actually next project director for SLV. SLV 3, he was a project director. First was a failure. Second was Dr. Kalam. Then third was, he is a project manager for, project director for SLV. So VP Sandlas, who stayed with Dr. Kalam for 20 years in his lodge and everything. You know him for 48 years, he was with Dr. Kalam. So he has written in his some of his book. And there was a, with Vikram Sarabhai, in his book he has written that. So 1968, Indira Gandhi went to use his visit. To visit the Trivandrum Thirds, Tumba Equatorial Rocket Landing Station to dedicate to UN. So at the time, the PA system in charge was given to VP Sandlas. Then Dr. Vikram Sarabhai came and he was checking the plane. And he see the dais, the podium was slightly higher, but not suitable to the height of Madam Indira Gandhi. So he make a man who is approximately equal to the height stand and adjust the podium by himself. So that much care he has taken. Yeah, because PM is coming, we must be doing everything correctly. So he took even the small thing also. Then, apart from that, there was a lot of noise. It was near the seashore was the podium. A lot of noise were coming. So he covered all the mic, right, with the paper and the cloth and everything, and make there was no disturbance when speaking. Apart from that, he airlifted the artificial turf was unknown. So he made the from Bombay, he ordered from through airlifted some of the turf, artificial turf, and played in the avenue to so that it will be. Apart from that, to motivate all the students, it's called Rohini engineers, all these juniors who are working in the Rohini, called Rohini engineers, call them, stand in a row, and introduce to Madam Indira Gandhi. So this is a way he's motivated the people. Even he has seen once in the South Block, when he went to meet one of his secretary, and he saw that that Vikram Sarabhai Gandhi is coming, walking hand in hand, and tell him, and Indira Gandhi telling him, Vikram, you manage your office in your own way. So these are the some of the incidents he recovered. Right? Then Nambi Narayan will be knowing, he's a liquid person. Nambi Narayan was a junior engineer, joined, and he was working in the office with all his drawing board and everything. He was very much involved in that. So somebody approached him in a white kurta and very simple dress with his chappals and everything. And so he doesn't know. So he asked him and he answered everything. Finally, Nambi Narayan asked him, what is your name, sir? Then he told, my name is Vikram. So Vikram Sarabhai is so simple and very accessible to even a junior engineers. And you will make everybody special as if he is close to her. That is his, one of his very good, fine quality. Junior or senior, you will think that he is for him. He will give full attendance to him. That is a way, right? He is a PG, so he did his PG, postgraduate in engineering in one of the government colleges in Trivandrum, engineering college. And when he comes to know that Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, he sent him to Princeton University, UK, with a NASA scholarship. In the 10 months, he prepared. So that's the way he helped the people who want to be helped. And Nambi Narayan was famous for his liquid propulsion, where others are doing solid propellant. And the liquid propulsion technology and cryogenic technology, Nambi Narayan has come back. He's become director of LPG also later. You can see a young Nambi Narayan during this RH times, right? The Princeton. Always introducing as a Princeton, me as our Princetonian during this college. That was his problem. Right? You must be knowing him, the gentleman. He is a man with his iconic figure. This is Dr. R. Amuran, who is sitting here in the famous figure. After President, he met him. So, what is he about? Even you can see him with all the chairman, even though he visited Bangalore recently. Vikram Sarabhai, but the centenary celebrations. See, he was recruited by Dr. Vikram Sarabhai. The interview was in Ahmedabad. And he's narrating, he's mesmeric. His plans, he came for the interview, and it is not like the interview. Actually, Dr. Vikram Sarabhai is selling his dream to Dr. Aram, that he was in the atomic energy in Bombay, leaving this government job, he's joining the VSSA. He took him to the nearest tracking station and showed him, described him everything. So that is very sincere. He one of the chosen few, right? So that was first meeting with him. Second meeting, when he was working in the TERS, from the reactor control, he is one of them side, and he came in between, and he took Baba inside, until he is one of your boy from control division, like that he introduced him, and tracking about your work, and he encouraged that around them to talk to Baba directly, anyway the work. This is the way he motivated, technical motivation is the best, right? Once there was an incident, there was in Australia, one used tracking station was coming for action. So instead of creating ourselves, Dr. Vikram Sarabhai tried to get that tracking center, telemetry tracking center, and send Dr. R. Ramdan and another person to go to Australia and participate in action get that. So they wanted a foreign exchange. At the time, foreign exchange was unheard. That's going to open demand draft. Foreign exchange they need. They went to Bombay Reserve Bank. Dr. Ramdan and colleague, he went to Bombay Reserve Bank. That clerk never meant anything. So foreign exchange is a big thing. He actually discredited them and sent them out. Then Ramdan directly phoned to Vikram Sarabhai, telling that there is a condition here. I am not getting the demand drop. Without demand drop, you cannot go and participate and everything. Okay, he agreed. You ask him to wait there. Within 10 minutes, the same clerk was running out and calling Dr. Ramdan inside and giving the royal treatment. He handed over the open draft DD to him. This is because he just a phone call to V.P. Jaban, who was a finance minister. So this is the way he solved the problem. This is the way he used his network, democratic, his network, his relation with the great leaders for the benefit of the people. So immediately within 2 minutes, they were given the draft and they went to Australia and get that tracking television station to TERS, right? once he went there, he wanted to, so he made all the people go. So Vikram Saravai, another good quality is he will send his people for training, either inland or abroad. So many instances we can see. He will train the people abroad and go and get that and tell it to our peers. One day, he asked Aravindan and other two senior engineers to visit all the space ports of worldwide. So immediately they made a list of space port and give it to him. On the spot, he approved that. If they're not going, so you go, you all go to go, all the three go and visit all the space port and come back. That was the spot direction and the training. He emphasized on training. Right? And always he is very simple. He always come in the kurta and paijama, right? Kolhapuri chappals, and he never keep money. If whenever he want money, the PA by the same will give the money, whatever the money, and he use a simple block belt pen and a HMD wristwatch. This is what I think. The simplicity is infected our Dr. Kalam also from him. That's what. So the simplicity is right. Kalam Aravindan telling he was like a god, right? He was there for college. He is our god. He is our vibrant leader. We loved and respected. He is the central pillar of the circus. You have seen the circus tent. It will be under one of the central pillar. First pillar it will come. So under this we are doing all our exercise. That's what he is revered. He is a pillar of a central pillar of a circus. That's what he used to do from Saravai. And he has mentioned another incident where he can see. And one or two people went to PRL. One is Aravindan, another is Kalam. Both of them were asked to come to Ahmedabad to meet Dr. Vikram Sarabhai. So it will take 2 days. One to Bombay, then Bombay to Ahmedabad. It will at least 2 to 3 days to reach Ahmedabad from Trivandrum, at those days by train. So these are not, but they are very junior, not much famous at the time, not well known. They are not that much big people at that time. They are also very junior engineers. So they went to Ahmedabad and they were reached there and they were unnoticed. They are in the, standing in the corridor, people are going, come and here, but nobody listened to them. And they themselves voluntarily talk to the people. So the people start complaining, these two people, two engineers from BSSE, Kalam and Aravindan, is disturbing our work, like that, they report. So they started fighting. He's very, actually, Kalam is a very good temper, soft spoken, and cool temper, start shouting in the corridor. So fighting with those people. So we are standing, we are not listening and everything. So half an hour, nothing has happened. The administrative office also come and gone. Immediately after half an hour, one person comes, sir, your waiting room is ready. You are officially you can go and sit down and wait. So the matter went to the Sarabhai, who was in a big meeting. Even in the big meeting, he got the complaint and immediately arranged. This is called Karam Nisha, the great corridor war. Right. So this is the way you take care of the people's problem. It is not that he is big, he is busy. He is ready to help anywhere. He knows every employee by name. Even junior, he will go and report with them so that he will feel that he is special. Special relation with Dr. M. Sarabhai. Once Aravindan landed in Bombay to go to Ahmedabad. So in the waiting room, he saw Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, the senior officer of Atomic Energy Commission. So immediately when Sarabhai located Aravindan and immediately came to him. He come from the crowd of the one and immediately invited him, where are you and everything, where are you going, what are you doing and everything. So from the big, among the big people, senior people, a junior is celebrated like this. So this is one of the incident, how we keep rapport with the junior people. This is one example here, this is one of his quality. Not only here, he has one Professor Hideo Itokawa from Japan. And he looked to him to a space science technology center. Went to another one. He involved in the design of the space science technology center. And he's a professor, Hideo Itokawa. And actually, Vikram Saravai requested him to place any Indian professors working abroad. And he brought lots of people from abroad to work. That way, he would the team. You see the team? Most of them in this team, Dr. A. Muthunayam, Dr. S. C. Gupta, Vasant Kavarikar. All are become directors of BSSE and LPSC center itself. He became Dr. Uthraim is famous for the Kudankulam issue also. He participated recently. He was the director of Oceanography now. After that, after BSSE, you can see Kalam and Sadish Shavan, Brahma Prakash, and he's a crew. He was the second state in charge of SLV. Dr. Isharadas and Aramdan. These people went to all Kalam, Isharadas and Aramdan. All the people went to NASA for a training, the initial training. Dr. Rane, computer, Dr. Madhavan Iyer, etc. Right, like that you can see a lot of people. Among these you can see Shriya Satya. He's the first man who joined Dr. Kalam as assistant in Bangalore, not advanced mechanical. He's Dr. Srinivasan, that is VSSC, VP Sandlas, you can tell I was told him. And Dr. Srinivasan, Dr. Sundaralajan, NTU University, he's in Singapore, visiting professor. Dr. Srinivasan no more, but he's a director of VSSC. Dr. Rajaram Navappa in Bangalore now available, he's there. And he met him recently also. All these people have become great. This is a team he built before he departs the world. He won't be able to pass the care. He a proponent. He had worked in the Atomic Energy Research Establishment in the UK and the British Ministry of Aviation also. At ISRO, he was responsible for the proponent in the chemicals and materials group. Swet Chandrakulwa, S.C. Gupta, became director of VSSC. He also became director of VSSC after that. S.C. Gupta, Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, doctorate in Peninsula. He has specialist in control system, guidance system, electronics. He has spent several years in the U.S. before landing in Durham in 1960. Dr. A. Muthunayam, the youngest in the group, a brilliant mechanical engineer and the Madras University, honors degree, and from the Indian Institute of Science, ME, and doctorate from University of Brunei. He was working at NASA when Sarabhai met him and bringing back to India. Right? He became the rocket propulsion chief in there. And V.J. Rao, Madras Institute of Technology, obtained a PhD in aeronautical engineering from the U.S. He was also years brought back to Trivandrum to work in SSTC. Dr. S. Rane, PhD in systems engineering. When Sarabhai picked him for the space program, first Rane come and they could adjust Trivandrum, went back. Again he come back and worked with ISRO. Right? He was when I was okay, he was a computational facilities center. Vikram Sarabhai Space Center. Then you are Rao, you know he's the chairman, he became the chairman, he was a student of Dr. Vikram Sarabhai. He became working in RPA PRL and raised in American Sphere during his stint at MIT. Right? When he visited, Sarabhai get him to and he was the Space Application Center at Bangalore named after him. You are our Space Application the headquarters. Similarly, R.D. John or the Madras PWD, he only constructed all the road, building, everything, all the infrastructure taken by him. Like this, he built people, M.C. Mathu, he's a MIT, my senior. And before joining SO, he worked in the Aeronautical Quality Assurance. And V.P. Kulkarni, he got a PhD in Electronics from Moscow University. Like this, he has built up. So he built an ordinary, you will be knowing iconic, right? His iconic photograph, and who is that? He's Mr. Sunil Satya. He's Dr. Satya. Yeah, in Dr. Advanced Metallurgy, he's in Bangalore now. So this is Mr. Satya who is explaining his brown. He was telling there was one good incident when first two, Nikkei Apache was the first sounding rocket launched in Mumbai. You very well know that it was given by that nose cone was given by America itself. Completely, the first stage is Nikkei, second stage is Apache. The payload glass fiber glass two flights they have given. That flight they didn't agree to give. So it is Satya to FRB, fiber reinforced plastic started, and he was made some rough machine of winding with the wire and everything. Immediately Kalam comes to know that. So he went and brought Dr. Vikram Sarabhai to show that. And he saw that immediately told, send him to next machine work, LMW Coimbatore. Then he arranged a tour for UK and then to UK, US to went around, get the knowledge and get back. That is his idea. To save time, his patriotism is okay, but suddenly buy whatever possible and buy to save time and convert it to our Indian condition and applicable to the mass. This was the line of thought of Dr. Vikram Sarabhai. So Pramod Kale, who is the director of ESSC after that, he also used to tell, NASA, the minimum was PhD so that they will know English. But without PhD, without a PhD, we can do well. Dr. Sarabhai has proved that. This way, right? What was coming to his last ambition before the week, 1 week before the end of 1971, right? So he went to his Ahmedabad to see his mother and he was telling what you are telling, discussing with the mother. He was telling, I was, what is your ambition, terrible ambition? He was telling science, science, and science. The science is in my heart, mind, and soul all time. I want to teach children science. This is where. So he told him, he come back to December 21. Again, he come back to Bombay. And he was scheduled to go to the Tumba, I mean Trivandrum. But he was called to Delhi for some other meeting. So I went in flight. And when we traveled in the flight, it was that Ramana was telling Atomic Commission Chairman after that. He was telling to Ramana in the flight that his blood pressure is swinging. So he wanted to take yoga and everything. So he come back to Bombay again. And from Ahmedabad, December 26th. And he went to Delhi and come back. And he wanted to go back to Tumba. Right, then he take a ticket and went to Tumba. When he completed the 28-29 was a hectic activities. One was Bailey station was open for the by people of the employees. There was a small station using his influence. He opened a very small railway station near Tumba Hills for the benefit of the employees. Even Anumandaya, who was the railway minister, came for inauguration. He looked tired in that event, the 26th. After there was continuous review in the SSTC chemical. And finally, he went to, even after all the meeting over in Tumba, he went to his hotel in Kuala. Then also meeting somebody. So there is the last meeting with Thakur, Jalathan Rao, Muthunayam, and Kirtanis and Mukherjee. And after that meeting is over, and Dr. Vasanth Gorikar was entering, again want to meet him some personal after the meeting, but he saw he was lying on the ground with a folded hand, so he didn't disturb him and come back. He's a person who last saw him. Then 10:30, there was a 10 o'clock Gorikar and come back, and 10:30 there was a phone from Kalam. From Delhi, he attended a meeting. After every meeting, he will use to phone Dr. Vikram Sarabhai and tell him what happened in the meeting. So 10:30 there's a call from Dr. Kalam, and he narrated what has happened. And Dr. Kalam was telling, you be in the airport. Morning I have to go to Bombay. We will have a meeting in the airport and we can go like that. So he's Delhi to Trivandrum, he came to meet him. That meeting never happened. So the last man to call is Dr. Kalam. Right? This is a castle where he breathed his last. This is a Kuala Motel. Right? A man. Drawn the first rocket to 21 November 2, right? Chandrayaan 2 up to that, last year. The man, attained lot of milestones, okay, from 2027. And lot of key milestones who achieved. ISRO achieved after him, it is because of his foundation. So it is to correct word, to end the webinar with his words of Robert Frost. The woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep. And might to go before I sleep, and might to go before I sleep. Right? Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. I hope this session has inspired our students a lot, and we came across many untold chapters of Vikram Sarabhai's life, and a pleasure for us indeed to have you on this occasion, sir. Students must fill their feedback form, and if anyone is having any kind of difficulty or technical issue, they can contact us on support@team2020.rf.gd. Now, on the behalf of Team 2020, I would like to extend my heartiest thanks to Professor Ilongovan for joining us in this event as a speaker, and we will be coming back with a lot more webinars and short courses and great stuff. Till then, stay safe, stay connected, and keep learning. Thank you very much, Team 2020. Team 2020.